Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how to create an iPhone ringtone using GarageBand. So I'm using GarageBand version 10 here, and I'm going to show you how to create a ringtone. A ringtone is actually one of the default project types when you start a new project. So we're just going to select that and start a ringtone project. So a ringtone project is really not fundamentally any different than most others. You've got tracks and you've got loops. Let's go and record some audio, for instance, with the microphone here. Ring, ring. So I've got that in there. Let's actually add just maybe a little bit of music here. Just something, little strings. Put that in the background. So now we've got some music and my voice. Ring, ring. So, and of course you can customize this. You can record anything you want with your voice. You can combine all sorts of loops and make a song. You can import audio from another track. Bring it all in here and create this ringtone. And a ringtone is essentially a loop. And you can see it's set with a loop here with this yellow area. We want to tighten that loop up because it's going to play the entire loop out as a ringtone. We want it to repeat the ringtone, as ringtones do, after a short period of time. So let's have it go this far, it'll play this, and we can even make this part loop like that, and then it'll return and play it again if it's a ringtone. Generally the idea is you can put anything you want in here, any number of loops, you can record from the microphone, you can record from other inputs, anything you do with GarageBand, even dragging and dropping other audio files in here and taking sections of them, as long as you end up with a track that has a looping section with cycling turned on of 40 seconds or less. And once you've got that, you're ready to send the ringtone over to iTunes. So make sure you've saved the file first, and I've saved the project as my ringtone. So now it has a name, and I can go share ringtone to iTunes, and it will open up iTunes, and the file will be in there. You have to switch your library to look at tones, and then you'll see your ringtone appear there in the list, and you can create more and fill this tone section up with all sorts of different tones. Now when you connect an iOS device, like for instance I've connected an iPad here, I can go into the sync settings, select tones, select sync tones, and select that tone or just all of the tones that I've got to sync. And then next time I sync that device, they will then appear in the lists for things like ringtones, text tones, and all sorts of messages and alerts. So you can really create an entire soundscape for your iOS device by using GarageBand on your Mac to create all sorts of interesting ringtones.